good. Now it's just a question of reassembling the components in the correct sequence.
I feel fear for the last time. A token funeral is held. There is nothing to bury. Janie frames the snapshot. It's the only photograph of me anyone has. A circulatory system is seen by the perimeter fence. A few days later, a partially muscled skeleton stands in the hallway and screams for a moment before vanishing.
Possibly the most significant event in recent history. We repeat, the Superman exists, and he is American.
They call me Dr. Manhattan. They explain the name has been chosen for the ominous associations it will raise in America's enemies. The marketing boys say I need a logo. If I'm to have a symbol, it shall be one I respect. They are shaping me into something gaudy. Something lethal. In January 1971, President Nixon asks me to intervene in Vietnam, something that his predecessors would not ask. A week later, the conflict ends. Some of the Viet Cong forces want to surrender to me personally. Hollis Mason, a retired costume hero, writes a book. In it, he calls my arrival the dawn of the superhero. I am not sure if I know what that means.